In this video, I want to prove the area of a circle using integration. Say this is a circle with radius r. Say this is center. This center, so this is origin 0, 0. And this is the radius of r. Okay, so this would be r, 0. And this would be 0, r. So we know the area of a circle is pi times radius squared. So the area of this circle we already know using the formula, which is pi times radius squared. So we want to prove this. And as calculus students, you should know the proof of area of a circle, which is so fundamental in many of the other concepts. Now, the idea is very simple. Say, if you find the area of this quarter cycle and then you multiply by 4, that will give you the area of the circle. Now, how do you find using calculus? Imagine this is a strip. Imagine this is a thin strip where the width is dx. The width of this strip is dx and the height is y. Okay, so now what's the equation of this circle? The equation of this circle is x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. Okay, so we're making y the subject. I can say y squared is equal to r squared minus x squared. And if you're considering the top part, the top part would be y is equal to square root of r squared minus x squared. And the bottom part would be minus square root of r squared minus x squared. So this is the formula for y. So this is y. Okay. So if you want to find the area of this strip, area of a strip is, if you consider this strip infinitesimally thin, you can consider that is base times height. Area of the strip is base times height. Okay, so your base is dx times y, or that is basically y times dx. Okay, so now if you add, you can imagine this part, this quarter circle, is made up of infinitesimally small strips. If you add all the strips, say this is the first strip, okay, starting here, and they say this is the last strip. So if you add all these infinitesimally thin strips, that will give you area of this quarter circle. That's the idea. And that you can do by integration. So the area of the circle, area of this circle with radius r, is the definite integration from 0 to r of y times dx. So dx is constant. Dx is an infinitesimally small width of the strip, and y keeps changing. So this is equal to integration from 0 to r of y. What is y? That is square root of r squared minus x squared dx. Okay, so this integration tells you this is the addition of all infinitesimally small thin strips from 0 to r. Of course, you have to put a 4 here because you got 4 quarters. So this is 1 quarter. Okay. So now this is where you have to do a trig substitution, because you can't integrate this function without doing a trig substitution. Okay, so this is equal to 4 times integration from 0 to r. I'm going to divide both these. I want to get a 1 here. In place of r squared, I want to get a 1. I'll tell you why later on. So this is r squared divided by r squared minus x squared divided by r squared dx. Now you have to do this, you have to adjust, because this is something that you have added on your own. So if you factor 1 over r squared out, you're going to get 1 over r out. Now to cancel that 1 over r, which is not in the original expression, you have to write an r here. I want you to pause this video and think about it, why I wrote an r. Because when you factor this 1 over r squared out of this radical, you're going to have 1 over r. And to cancel that 1 over r, I'm writing an r here. So this expression and this expression are the same. So this is equal to 4r times integration from 0 to r of square root of 1 minus x squared over r squared dx. Okay, so now what are we going to do? Now we're going to do a trig substitution. So you should be knowing the trig identity of sine squared plus cos squared is 1. I'm going to let this as sine squared. So if this whole thing is sine squared, you can have square root of 1 minus sine squared, that is square root of cos squared. Okay, so let me explain that. So I'm going to use this identity. The purpose of doing this substitution is this identity. We know sine squared theta or cos squared theta plus sine squared theta, or sine squared theta plus cos squared theta is equal to 1. That's the identity that I'm seeing here in this expression. So I'm going to say let x squared over r squared is equal to sine squared theta. R is a constant. Okay, so x squared is equal to r squared sine squared. Okay, so now what will happen if you take square root? I can say, well, x is equal to r sine theta. Okay, so now we want to change the whole thing in terms of theta. So this value, or the lower bound and the upper bound, are with respect to x. Okay, so that has also to change. So now dx has also to change in terms of d theta. So I'm going to differentiate this. So I can say, well, what is dx by d theta? And differentiation of sine is cos, r is just a constant, so that is r cos theta. So this implies I can say dx can be substituted by r cos theta d theta. So this is one substitution that I'm going to do. Okay, so now I have to change the lower and the upper bound. So what do we know? We know this x is equal to r sine theta. So let me do the working here. So one value of x is, if x is equal to 0, can I say, putting this in this expression, can I say r sine theta is 0? R sine theta should be 0, because r sine theta is x. So that means sine theta is equal to 0. Sine theta is equal to 0. Now if sine theta is 0, what is theta? Well, we know sine 0 is 0, so theta has to be 0. So when x is 0, theta is 0, or the angle is 0. Okay, so let me do the other expression. If x is equal to r, I can say r is equal to r sine theta. Now dividing both sides by theta, I can say sine theta is equal to 1. Sine theta is equal to 1. And we know sine of 90, or sine pi by 2, is 1. So theta has to be pi by 2. Okay, by the way, in integration you have to use radians. Okay, for this you have to use radians. I'm going to use pi by 2. Okay, so here I have rubbed this off so that I need space here. So we came till here. So this is, I'm going to change this whole thing in terms of, this is where we ended and we did a substitution. So this changes to, can I write this is equal to, now I'm going from year to year backwards. So I can say this is 4r integration. When x is 0, theta is 0. So I can put replace 0 by 0. And when x is r, theta is pi by 2. So that changes to pi by 2 times integration of 1 minus, what is x squared over r squared? Well, x squared over r squared I've substituted as sine squared theta, times what is dx? Well, dx is r cos theta d theta, r cos theta d theta. So this becomes 4r times integration from 0 to pi by 2, and 1 minus sine squared is cos squared, and square root of 1 minus cos squared is going to be cos theta. So this is cos theta times r cos theta d theta. Okay, so I have rubbed this off. I need more space here. Okay, so now this has become, this r can be taken out because it's a constant. So this is 4r squared times integration from 0 to pi by 2 cos squared theta d theta. Okay, now there's no integration for cos squared theta, but we're going to use the double angle formula. You can refer in your books. There is a double angle formula like this. So let me write it here. So cos 2 theta is 2 cos squared theta minus 1. This is the double angle formula. This formula can also be used as a power reduction formula. So if you have got, if make cos squared the subject, I hope you can understand, cos squared theta is cos 2 theta plus 1 divided by 2. Okay, so this becomes, so this is 4r squared times integration from 0 to pi by 2 of cos 2 theta plus 1 divided by 2 d theta. So cos squared changes to this. Now it's possible, we can integrate cos 2 theta. So now this will, I'll do it here. So this is integration from 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so I don't want this. So plus 1 divided by 2 d theta. So 2 cancels with, this will become, so this is 2r squared times integration from 0 to pi by 2 of cos 2 theta plus 1 d theta. Okay, so what will happen now? So now you can integrate this and integrate this with respect to theta. So this is equal to, so I'll write it here. So this is 2r squared times integration from 0 to pi by 2. Now integration of cos theta is minus sine theta, but you got minus 2 here, so you have to do the opposite of differentiation. So this is minus sine 2 theta minus sine 2 theta divided by 2, and integration of 1 d theta is theta. Okay, sorry, I have to write it like this. I'm integrating now. So if you're integrating, you have to remove the integration sign. So now let me do it here. So this is equal to, this is 2r squared. So integrating cos 2 theta is minus sine 2 theta divided by 2. Okay, or think like this, if you differentiate this, you will get this back. and integration of 1 d theta is theta, and then you have to put the bounds, lower and the upper bounds, like this. So that's the area of the circle. Okay, so now we can say area of circle is equal to 2r squared of theta minus sine 2 theta divided by 2 for the bound from 0 to pi by 2. Okay, so this is, we're almost there, so this is 2r squared. So now you have to put back pi by 2 and then take away 0 from this by substituting. So in place of theta you can put pi by 2, so this is pi by 2, pi by 2 minus sine, so 2 times pi by 2 is going to be pi divided by 2, take away, then you have to put 0 here, so in place of theta you can put 0 minus, oops, it is not theta, it is 0, so if you put 0 minus sine, and if you put 0 back here, so sine of 2 times 0 is 0 over 2. Okay, I've squeezed it in. So this is equal to 2r squared times, this is pi by 2. This is pi by 2. Sine pi or sine 180 is 0. So 0 divided by 2 is 0. This is 0 and sine 0. This is not theta, this is 0. So sine 0 is 0 divided by 2 is 0. So this is just pi by 2. And so this 2 and 2 gets cancelled. So the final area of the circle is pi times radius squared. Hooray! So this is how you can use calculus or integration to find the area of a circle.